Here is a new cassette recorder. It's RadioShack CTR-120. It's a much newer machine than what I'm used to, actually. Well, yeah. But it's still a cassette recorder. It's still very high quality machine. It's very solid, solidly well built, and it uses AC bias, and it's the same size as a regular shoebox. Now I'll grab one as an example. Oops, the box screen. That's the Baycrest, and here's a somewhat smaller one. This is the one next to it is a realistic from the 80s. We've already seen a presentation of that, and we have yet to see a presentation of this. I got this one before I got that, but I haven't gotten around to doing a presentation of this. But this one's the star of the show. Okay, we got record, which is one touch. I'm not going to bother demonstrating that, but there's also a microphone there, condenser, play, rewind, fast forward, stop and eject, and pause. Good mechanical pause. It's got sort of odd contours, really. This part sort of sticks out from the rest of it. Volume control, microphone, remote, earphone, auxiliary line in, and 6-volt power. Runs on 4C cells. There's the label at the bottom. Radio Shack. Doesn't actually say, manufactured in China. It's not made by Tandy, obviously. Oh yeah, it is division of Tandy, but not by Tandy. There's this battery record light there. And it says CTR-120 AC battery cassette recorder. Has automatic stop, which works in all functions, rewind, fast forward, whatever. The speaker is located right there, rather than up like over here or something. So let's see how she sounds. It's AC bias. That's a brand new cassette. Sometimes the door doesn't say closed unless you push it down right there. Making a test recording on the RadioShack CTR-120 compact cassette recorder. This is a more modern machine. It's currently running on AC current. I'm trying to use, actually I'm being successful, I've already tried recording this machine more than once. I'm trying the internal condenser microphone. I'm now going to switch to the external microphone for the ICO. Okay, now using the ICO's microphone, which is the only cassette recorder microphone that I actually have. I'm assuming that this machine is AC bias. It seems to be. All previous recordings were really done on with the condenser microphone, which isn't very good for telling whether it's AC or DC bias. I'm thinking it's AC bias, or very, very good quality DC bias. Let's see how this goes. Remote does work on this machine. Using the internal condenser microphone, again, I'm now going to hook up a line-in source so I can do a music test recording.
I hope WMG doesn't come after me for this. I used that to record off of.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, cause I always wanted me one that was long and black.
Probably my favorite Johnny Cash song.
One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000.
They actually built an example of this.
One piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost
they assembled the Cadillac into spare parts.
You know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style. I'm gonna drive everybody wild. Cause I'll have the only one there is around.
It was this, I've used this, don't worry, I'm not going MP3, this is just a seldom used one. I got it for, I think it was either my birthday or my Christmas, I can't remember, but it's not a very expensive one. It's sort of an iPod knockoff. It works well for what it's intended for, but I normally don't really use it. These are for, I'm going to skip ahead to another part in the song, because it sounds very, very nice. Also, there's the AC jack on this side, as noted by that cord.
I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me.
Okay, I gotta go back a bit.
Now the headlight, four shocks, with the lunchbox like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, with the big stuff we snuck out my buddy's mobile home. Now up to now my plan went all right.
This is funny. This is a good image.
We put it all together one night, and that's when we noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73, and when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, we had that engine running just like a song.
Is this thing funny if they actually built one? Because they did actually.
There was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right, but when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on.
It's kind of interesting.
The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, well, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin.
It'd be hilarious.
About
so we tried to register
my
one.
My wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. But she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we drove uptown just to get the tags, and I headed to right on down Main Drag. I could hear everybody laughing for blocks around.
That'd be kind of interesting. Look on the internet to see if you can find a picture of that car, because it was hilarious. I saw the picture. It was dated 72. I could be wrong, but it was a very interesting looking car. Hope I'm not dragging the video on. The automatic stop does work when it's plugged in, when the battery's in it. Since it sounds like when it's played music recorded on it. It has a bit more bass when it's played with a different tape in it. There goes the automatic stop. It's a very nice machine. And if you find one and you're looking for a modern one that works good, get that. I only paid $5 for it, the same as I paid for all of them. I hope you enjoyed the presentation.